Welcome back, everyone. High Tech Lab here. Just wanted to show you guys the pile of batteries that have been taken out of service here on the ranch. These ones are all pretty much toasted, like no life left. A lot of these ones right in here are just no good, and those we've had for a while. But these group 8D batteries right here, those are no good. As you can see, this one right here is the one with the cracked lid. These batteries all on this pallet, all eight of these, are sitting at 10.5 volts. They have one low cell. I even marked on this one that it's sad. These ones, there's these two and this one, they're not happy because they were ran low on water. And then this battery, that battery, and this battery were all getting hot, and then I load tested them and they were no good. So these batteries, I'm thinking there may be a way to recover one cell, but I don't have the time or resources to do that. So I'm gonna extend the offer to any California viewers that want to pick up any of these batteries. Send me an email. I'll have my email address in the description. But I'm looking to get rid of some of these batteries and recoup a little bit, because California has a $20 core charge on these, and I'd like to at least get that, because I can take that to any recycler and get it. So if anybody is interested in these batteries, though, do send me an email. One of the things that I did accomplish this week was I got the whole second rack here in the battery room removed. So this is all open, and I painted the walls. Got everything ready, because most likely my new lithium cells are gonna go right here on the floor. I was considering painting the floor, but I'm not sure that I'm going to be doing that anymore. Just for the fact that this is actually a high traffic area when you consider everything, and I don't know that paint's gonna be the best idea. But I am open to suggestions on floor options. I was looking into epoxy floors, but they're a little out of the price range. Just trying to get better look then. I don't know if you guys can see very well. I'm not very good at painting. I do not like painting, and I've gotten quite a bit of a mess here on the floor. I also got back in here behind this shelving unit. You can kind of see the line of where some of the darkness I was painting over is. But we pulled out this whole top shelf of batteries I did on my own. These wires right here, you may be wondering, this is the 48 volt feed into my PLC cabinet. And that runs negative off of there and positive off of there. That is gonna be getting removed. That whole conduit is gonna be removed. And I'll most likely run it straight through the wire way above and come down. Probably I'll make this hole right here, most likely a 2-inch conduit similar to that one, and come straight down and tie onto the batteries that way, I imagine. Still need to figure out battery management system for those lithium batteries. Part of the problem is this inverter here, if we go in the menu and we go to the low battery voltage shutoff point, I only have 40 volts and 42 volts as options. So using this inverter, this is the inverter that powers everything on the ranch, and using this one as a low battery shutoff to protect those lithium cells is not gonna work. So I need a proper battery management system with a contactor of some sort to disconnect those batteries from this inverter. One of the other things I'll be doing next week is I'm actually gonna be removing a handful of these buttons from this panel. I ordered a HMI panel from Automation Direct, a 10-inch LCD widescreen. And I'll be integrating that and removing most of these wires, because I can make it all buttons on the touchscreen. And what that actually frees up is that frees up this entire section of terminal blocks. I won't need that anymore. One of the other things I'll possibly be doing is right now I have this number 12 10 conductor SO cord going into this generator. What I was driving last night and had the idea of doing is removing this box and putting a panel, a waterproof panel here, and having one of those click PLCs right on this generator, powered off the 12 volt battery in the generator. And then what that'll allow me to do is I can then pull analog inputs off of the amperage meters and frequency meters and voltage meters, as well as the hour meters and fuel meters. And then what that'll cause is I'll no longer need this giant cord that carries power, because I can connect to that PLC via Ethernet. So then whenever this generator needs to go somewhere, they can just disconnect an Ethernet cable instead of having to match up all the colors. Mainly thinking about this for my stepdad as he gets older, trying to keep things as simple, stupid, and error-free as possible. And then I can also tie in through those analog sensors to that HMI panel inside. And that will allow me to have a screen on here, and I can show generator voltage, frequency, amperage on A phase, amperage on B phase, fuel level, all sorts of statistics like that can all be shown on this HMI panel. And then what that also does is that eliminates these four relays, actually these six relays that are engaging with the generator. So all in all, it's an option that will free up a bunch of space in here. And then another thing I have coming up is this is a wind speed sensor I purchased on Amazon for right around 45 bucks. It's an in-speed, just off Amazon. I'll link it in the description. And if you look here, I'm tied into one of the inputs on the PLC. I'm gonna spin this. I know this is a little tight place, but you can see if you watch that light, it's blinking. So this PLC has high speed input, and that high speed input will allow me to capture wind speed. And then I can also tie in, I can get an analog input module and tie into this PLC, and I'm gonna be building my own solar tracker. This is the sun sensor that normally tracks throughout the day. And I have the control box up here. It's not a very good setup. It's very honestly hacked together, but I had to get it up and running in the pinch of time. The problem is in springtime and summer, the sun comes from this direction. So it hits this panel nicely and catches in the morning. Well, in wintertime, it comes from that direction. And there's just enough shading when these are flat at night, there's just enough shading where this sensor doesn't pick up the sun early in the morning. So what I'm gonna do is I will have those solar panels moving based on the PLC at a time of day to get moving in the morning, and then they'll use the sun sensor once it catches on, when the sun is near perpendicular to the panels, and then those will help lock it on. And then at the end of the day, I can do a very specific time to get these perfectly flat, because right now the panels are a little crooked. So that's the plan, building that PLC solar tracker, and I'll make video on that. It'll also tie in when I build the other tracking rack I've talked about previously on the channel. So I'm getting ready to head back out of town. I'll be back in town next week to get switched over to the lithium batteries. One thing I want to point out that a lot of people have been concerned about is overcurrent protection. I'm down to only one 300 amp fuse. Now this fuse was donated by Chris Bowden, and if you like the awesome on this channel, check out his channel. He builds cool stuff. Plenty of awesome content on his channel. Be sure to check it out. I'm going to be getting out of here, guys. Thank you for watching, and be sure to subscribe to stay tuned for more and more awesome videos. And I will see you guys next time. Bye-bye.